against Hacksaw Jim Duggan.
And get on the phone and call anybody you know, because we also have here today the Nature Boy, 13 times heavyweight champion of the world, Ric Flair is here.
Ric Flair will be here, plus Harlem Heat and High Voltage, crisp and wide action, and a whole lot more. As we are in the month of February, that means Super Brawl is right around the corner. But right now, stand to attention, Mr. Heenan. It's time for the red, white, and blue, and the real American, Hacksaw Jim Duggan.
Now if they can just point him to the doorway, he should be out here in an hour and a half. There he is.
Oh, yeah. I know you like to say some very disparaging remarks about Duggan, but this is a man's man. Red, white, and blue, Hacksaw Jim Duggan.
With the mind of a caterpillar. He's a man's man, all right. The big tough guy, there's no doubt about that. You ever see the size of the hands on him?
Oh, he's one of the biggest in our sport.
He could palm a bowling ball.
Well, speaking of the term, the adjective big, you're not going to find any bigger night than we have for you fans on a Sunday night, February 22nd, from the legendary Cal Palace in San Francisco, California, where that night, that one night, the biggest return match our grand sport's ever been a part of, as Hollywood Hogan and Sting will vie for the world title. This is a return bout, but as you know, the title vacated. Neither man has the belt. We'll finally find out who the undisputed world champ is coming up on the 22nd.
I think the people should remember this, that they're going to be part of history. Both men, Hogan and Sting, are going into this match. Neither are champion, but one will walk out of this as the WCW World Heavyweight Champion. There'll be no countouts, no timeouts, qualifications, none of that. There will be a champion crowned at the Cow Palace.
During the course of this telecast, a special look at Hollywood Hogan and Sting as we prepare for Super Brawl 8. Plus, we'll take you back to Thunder recently and show you how Kevin Nash has been fined, but how he has no regard at all. Outside goes the Barbarian for WCW. Take you back to Nitro, where the Macho Man Randy Savage and the NWO are seemingly still having their problems more than ever now.
Oh, they're having big problems. They had a lot of problems, and they all started when Bret Hart came to WCW, and it all started with Hogan losing the world championship. They're starting to crumble right in front of our eyes.
Hacksaw on the outside giving a little chase towards Jimmy Hart. And as he comes back in, there you see the Barbarian taking advantage here.
Well, the Barbarian will take an advantage, just like Jimmy Hart will whenever the opportunity arises.
The Barbarian back to the attack once again. Can you imagine the gall, how bold, how brazen Nick Patrick would be to get out as he did on Thunder recently? He said that he wanted to be considered the referee for the return match of Hogan and Sting at Super Brawl.
Well, he hasn't been found guilty of anything. They're just investigating. That's why they held the title. They never said he did count fast or didn't count fast.
I said he did.
Well, of course you said he didn't. It looks that way to me, too, a bit. But like he said, that makes sense. Every referee has their own way of officiating the match.
Big, massive bear hug.
And what do you got to be mad at him about? He's the one that counted Hogan down. You should be happy at that.
No, he counted Sting down.
Well, yeah, but basically, you know what I mean.
Yeah, I know your lame brain is what I know. Big bear hug and a headbutt. He has counted Hogan down before, but I can tell you, Nick Patrick, I'm sure, is going to be nowhere near San Francisco on the 22nd in Super Brawl. Duggan's coming back here. Look at this. Eyes are starting to blink.
No, eye is starting to blink.
Eyes.
Oh.
And Duggan. Oh, biting the Barbarian. That'll get you out of a bear hug.
That'll get you out of a bear hug with a bear. Duggan starts biting on you. Just a breath alone will make that big animal run north.
And now Duggan with those big hands, those massive hands and forearms you talked about. He's got Jimmy Hart.
Oh. Yeah. See, Duggan knew he was coming.
He could feel it.
He outsmarted the Barbarian, which is, for Duggan, that's a feat.
Drops Old Glory on him, the knee, and it's
he
over.
He got him.
Hacksaw Jim Duggan. They love him here at Universal Studios, Florida, and they love him around the world. A former United States heavyweight champ, and I believe can be back in the title hunt again.
I'm so glad to be at the best, NWO. I'm looking for you, tough guy. Oh!
world's biggest termite.
Oh, would you stop with those remarks? He's a great wrestler. He's a great American. And a fine man, Hacksaw Jim Duggan. Thumbs up from the crowd here, Brain.
When's your birthday?
November.
He's yours. Big knee drop by Duggan on the Barbarian. Covers him, refereeing position. The 1, 2, 3. Barbarian's going no place. Your winner. Ho! Hacksaw Jim Duggan.
It's our 1-800-COLLECT-SLAM of the week. 1-800-COLLECT-THE-WAY we call today. Let's go to Lee Marshall.
Hi, everybody. Lee Marshall here. We're going to be getting right back to the action, but I think wrestling fans all over the world are still trying to figure out exactly what's going to happen at the next big WCW pay-per-view based on what happened at Sold Out. I'm speaking directly of James J. Dillon and Rowdy Roddy Piper, saying that on February 22nd in San Francisco at the WCW Super Brawl number 8, Hollywood Hogan and Sting will fight to determine who is the WCW heavyweight champion of the world. The title's vacant now, but it's going to be filled at Super Brawl 8. Fans, there are two ways for you to see this. Either get to San Francisco on the 22nd, or hook up to see this one on pay-per-view. You satellite owners, contact DirecTV, the Dish Network, Turner Home, your local cable operators, of course, to see it on pay-per-view. That's February 22nd, Hollywood Hogan and Sting at Super Brawl 8. I know that Eddie Guerrero wants to be at Super Brawl. Eddie, you told me you'd walk through glass to get there and an opportunity to go after the Cruiserweight Championship of the world. I know San Francisco, particularly California, you got a lot of fans there.
Well, I wouldn't say fans, maybe just acquaintances.
Because
every time I'm there, they yell Eddie, but something always precedes it, which I cannot say on TV. Huh. Think you know a people, and then they turn their backs on you.
There was a time in California the Guerrero name was golden.
You don't have to tell me about that. The point is, Super Brawl.
Mm-hmm.
What a great, great pay-per-view that's going to be. I'm kind of looking forward to seeing it. The other point is, Guerrero Land. That's right. You know it. I know it. And there's nothing you can do about it. I should be there. I want to be there. I'm going to be there. As far as Chris Jericho, all you're doing is running around, acting like a fool. I'm going to beat that fullness out of you.
I know California's famous for Disneyland, but fans, Guerrero Land, I mean, I wouldn't even know which exit off the freeway you'd take to get to Guerrero Land.
Welcome back to Worldwide, everyone. Tony Schiavone, Bobby the Brain Heenan, still to come during the course of this telecast. Some of the greatest wrestling action in the world this week here on Worldwide. Later on here in the month of February, February 22nd, Super Brawl 8 will have the rematch the world has waited for. WCW's vacated world heavyweight title will finally be decided. Sting and Hollywood Hogan will go one-on-one.
Well, this is what I want to see, and this is what should happen. Throw them in there, put the belt at the ringside, and let them fight. Last man walks out of there, wins the title. This is the way it should have been a long time ago. And Hogan, I don't think you're going to walk out of there. I think you're going to be carried out of there, because I think Sting is going to win the world championship.
Sting's a determined man. Don't forget, it wasn't too long ago that Hollywood Hogan thought that we would hand the belt right back to him. Remember when that happened? Right now, let's go to the ring with more action this week on Worldwide Wrestling.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following is a one-fall contest. Introducing first, from Edmonton, Alberta, Canada, the Crippler, Chris Benoit.
And pound for pound, you're not going to fight a better wrestler in the entire world than this man, the Crippler, Chris Benoit.
Well, he earned that name, not Benoit, not Chris, but the Crippler.
A lot of talk about Benoit not getting his due as far as major title shots are concerned, and coming up very soon, he's going to be getting some title shots. And hopefully on this program, Chris Benoit will come in as a champion. He's in the ring. His opponent to be announced as we go back to David Penzer on Worldwide.
His opponent from Havana, Cuba, David Sierra.
David Sierra, the Cuban native, going one-on-one against Benoit. Here we go.
Well, Benoit's given away about, I would say, 50 pounds.
Yeah, every bit 50, 60 pounds here.
But he's got so much speed. And there's so much fight in that man.
Yeah. The thing about Benoit is he goes in with reckless abandon. He absolutely fears no man. He approaches the match 110 miles an hour. And a lot of times he takes some punishment, as you're seeing. But it seems like Benoit continues to get up. It seems like you cannot hurt this man.
Well, Sierra's a veteran. He knows what to do in that ring. He's laying it into Benoit. He's keeping him down. He's pounding at him. I don't know if that's going to work.
Benoit coming back, like we said, in the midsection. Again, pounding away on the back of the neck is Sierra. Sierra really leveling Benoit here in the opening moments.
That 50 pounds is making a difference right now.
Do not forget, fans, we still have to come in this program, the Nature Boy, Ric Flair.
He'll be wrestling.
Want to remind you that Super Brawl is here at Super Brawl 8. It's on Sunday, February 22nd. Hollywood Hogan and Sting divide for the Undisputed World title, which has been vacated. Who will prevail? Plus, no disqualification. The Macho Man Randy Savage and Lex Luger and Buff Bagwell against Scott Steiner. More matches to be announced in the weeks to come. Super Brawl 8. Make the call. Order this event. And join us on pay-per-view on Sunday, February 22nd.
Well, Benoit's conditioning, I think, here is taking over. He's been pounded on, he's been beat on a lot, but he's in such great physical shape, he's got such determination. But him and Sierra have gone toe-to-toe right here.
Headbutt by Benoit. Ric Flair, as we said, in the feature bout. Plus, we're going to see Tenzan out of Japan. Here's a cover. Charles Robinson over to make a two count. Charles Robinson, great official who was recently pummeled, powerbombed by Kevin Nash. Although he's sore and bruised, a few weeks later, he's back into the action here. Kevin Nash, as you know, has been told about the powerbomb. Powerbomb has been outlawed in WCW, the powerbomb. Will get you immediate disqualification and fined. And that's really changed the course of our sport, Brain.
Well, it certainly has. And we said in 98, things are going to change here. And they have a new no-nonsense attitude here with J.J. Dillon and Rowdy Roddy Piper. They're going to, well, you saw they fined Kevin Nash at the beginning, $50,000. That's more than you make some weeks.
More than I make some years.
Kidding.
Up on top, a flying headbutt by...
That's with tips, though.
Yes, by Chris Benoit.
And you get your parking validated.
Would you shut up for a second?
He's going back... $8,000 a year, basically.
Yeah, full-arm drag. Quez drives him down. Crippler crossface.
Tap out. He's had enough. Now, remember when Chris Benoit had this on Raven. Raven loved it.
You're talking about what transpired and sold out. Yeah, Raven seemed to enjoy the pain of the crippler crossface.
Never tapped out, just smiled and drifted off into unconsciousness. That's a sick birdie right there.
So the crippler scores yet another win. And when he really gets going, when he is... Oh, my goodness, look at this. I didn't even realize they were at ringside. Raven's flock. Raven not going anywhere near him this week now, is he?
Good move. Benoit here so quick. Knocks the big man Sierra down. Comes off that top rope. Look at this. Raven, take a good look. There's a big bird you don't want to mess with. Takes him down. Just a matter of time until the big man from Cuba taps out. Your winner, the crippler, Benoit.
The NWO still having problems with one Macho Man Randy Savage as we take you to footage from Nitro. Hollywood Hogan and Sting, the world waits. The biggest buildup, the biggest anticipation for the two biggest stars in our sport, one with the NWO, one with WCW, neither man with the title. But coming up on the 22nd of February, one man will walk away to the Cow Palace. And you can see on pay-per-view the new World Heavyweight Champion.
Definitely, there will be a winner. There will be a new champion crowned at the Cow Palace. I understand this team here has been over in Europe, over in the Orient, doing quite well.
They are two of the youngest, most powerful men that we've had on this program in a long, long time. And High Voltage must contend with this duo. A team that hasn't been teaming together that much as of late, Brain, and that's because, well, we have seen Booker T, the television champ, have a lot more singles matches because he's a TV champ. But you can't deny these two men are great, former 7-time World Tag Team Champions.
Well, Stevie Ray's had a some bad luck recently, a few injuries here and there. Booker T's gone it alone and championship caliber right now. Everybody's talking about him. He's adapted for tag team wrestling into the singles ranks. It'll be a good match. Four big, strong guys.
Hylam Heat will meet High Voltage, one of our feature bouts. We'll have the tag team match in its entirety when we come back from Universal Studios, Florida on Worldwide. There's your bell. You see Raven's Nest still at ringside here. Watch it on as we go to this tag team matchup with Mickey J, the assigned referee. And the fans getting into this. Well, we've talked about, and you've seen the footage from Nitro. The Macho Man Randy Savage has painted himself into a corner now, Brent. He has what he wants. He has Luger no disqualification at Super Brawl coming up on the 22nd in about 2 weeks. And he has no one to help him out, I would feel, from the NWO, as we've seen the footage from Nitro.
Well, he's crazy enough. He said he don't. Oh, look at this. Look at this. That's power. Well, he said he don't want any help. They said they wouldn't help him. There's a lot of trouble there. But Savage should understand. That shows you how goofy this guy is. And he wants Luger in a no disqualification match, so he can do whatever he wants to Luger. I don't know if he realizes that also worked for Luger. Luger can do anything he wants to Savage. The no-win situation.
Booker T stepping through. And rage comes out of that. You know, you're right. They are so powerful, these two young men. And this is where Booker T does not want to be. Tag made. Chaos now in.
They're going to a new look to his dude, don't he?
Yeah, he does. He's a very odd personality, is Chaos.
Is that his real hair or is that Berber carpeting?
That's his real... Oh, would you please stop? Oh!
No! That's a real kick to the app.
The version of the spin wheel kick. And the fans love Harlem Heat. They want him to raise the roof here on Worldwide. Into the midsection he goes. Forearm shot. Staggers his head to the back.
His head whipped back there?
Pounding the man in the back of the head.
Now, funny things can happen here. A lot of guys go overseas, when they go to the Orient or to Europe. They come back, they may not know the new ruling here. You may see guys power bombing people, they don't even know they can't do that anymore. There should be some grace period for them.
To the ropes, ducking low, catching Booker T. Rage, look how strong he is, and walk out! Oh my goodness!
I thought he was going to spike him. Don't waste your time now. Here's your opportunity. Get a win.
A little bit too much showboating, and he got out of it, boy. I tell you, that may cost him in this match.
It did. You get Booker T 3 or 4 extra seconds there to get his win back. You can't pin him.
Almost pinned the world television champion, did Rage. And Booker T explodes over the near side ropes with a forearm shiver to the forehead.
Peg your big brother.
Locked him. It's been all Booker T. He has not been able to make a tag to Stevie Ray.
Oh!
Now he's trying to get that. And he does.
The big one's in.
Stevie Ray. Harlem Heat. Combination. Left, right, left. To the ropes. Down
go both members
of High Voltage.
Oh!
And the fans are loving this here, Brain. Here they go. Teamwork, the hallmark of Harlem Heat. Up, time for the Big Apple.
Oh! 3 points, a field goal.
Not going to get up here, fans.
No.
What an awesome duo. Former World Tag Team Champ. Certainly Booker T. Firmly entrenched in singles competition with being the world TV champ together there, Harlem Heat.
You know what they did here? Booker T stayed in there long enough. He stayed in there long enough and weathered the fight. He let High Voltage tag in and out, in and out, in and out. Meanwhile, he took the beating knowing he was going to tag his brother, a fresh, big Stevie Ray. And that's what happened. And he came in and cleaned house. See him right here. Dropped him with that big kick. Right here, I thought High Voltage could have got a win. Big, powerful men, all four of them. You can't take anything away from any one of them. Watch this kick. Bang, right along the side of the head. No matter how tough you are, you're not going anyplace for a while. You're winners! Harlan Heat.
Coming up next, a member of the NWO, Tenzon, plus the Nature Boy, Ric Flair, and much more. But let's take you... Would you be quiet? Kevin Nash then handcuffed and taken away one more time. Well, deservedly so. I don't know how much fines were levied from attacking a referee, but too much is not enough in this case.
And the good thing about them putting him in the sneezer, we'll always be in touch with Kevin Nash. Because eventually he'll be making our license plate.
Tenzon of the NWO comes out here. That's right, fan. Pose. You're a fan of a guy like Kevin Nash. No regard for law and order, no regard for authority, no respect for what has happened in this sport. Whatever they get, they deserve. And I tell you, they are literally, as we saw earlier in this program, having their problems. I say falling apart at the seams as we take a look at Tony Carr, Tenzon's opponent. But whatever they get, they richly deserve. They are no good. And I'm saying that from the top with Eric Bischoff all the way to their brand newest member, Dusty Rhodes. They're no good.
I couldn't agree with you more, Mr. Schiavone.
You wanted to be part of it one time.
No, I was infiltrating them.
Yeah, I got your infiltration.
I'm a double agent. I was doing that. I threw myself in front of the truck for you.
What a Ryan remind you, though, fans, that Super Brawl 8 will be the night this New World Order gets a chance to put its money where its mouth is, because Hollywood Hogan is not the champ. Sting is not the champ. But that night, a brand new champion will be crowned. The two biggest stars in our sports, the two most powerful organizations, will collide in the biggest night in wrestling, Super Brawl 8. It's Sunday, the 22nd of February at 7 o'clock Eastern Time. Order now. Make that order. Don't be left out, and join us for Super Brawl.
Tenzon's a big guy. Quick, too. Very quick hand.
I think Tenzon shows you the influence the NWO has nationwide and worldwide as well.
What's he got on his tights there?
Looks like a caricature of a steer.
Does Oprah know that?
That's not funny. Headbutt.
So naturally where that steer is, it,
don't talk.
You might say it'd be kind of like a rump roast.
Oh, boy. Tony Carr trying to gut wrench that time, but into a side headlock goes Tenzon. Tenzon is a very odd-looking figure, I know that, but he is very talented. One of the finest stars from Japan, I tell you. You're talking about Masahiro Chono and Tenzon and the great Muda all becoming members of the New World Order.
They're surrounding us. But it doesn't matter, Tony, because they don't have a leader. Bischoff is trying to be the peacekeeper here. Savage isn't getting along with anybody. Nash and Hogan are getting along. I don't know about Hall and Hogan. And now I don't know about Norton and Bagwell. But then again, don't forget you got Vincent, who never really has really gotten along with Conan, I don't think. But then if you
I get your point here. They're not getting along.
Who?
Down goes Tony Carr. Sound like you're in the midst of one of Rhodes' filibusters.
What?
Never mind.
It's not his fault he talks like that. If you ate 20 pounds of hay a day, you'd speak like that, too.
I guess you would. To the top of the head goes Tenzon. Tenzon right now is just... What he's doing is showing up Tony Carr, trying to inflict pain and injury on Tony Carr. And a man, I think it's very obvious that he could pin or get to submit at any time here.
Well, Tony Carr is a... relatively newcomer in the sport, but Tenzon just has the experience. He's got that conditioning. He's got that mentality of the NWO.
Tenzon.
That's using your head.
You're not kidding. That was very close to being a low blow and a warning from Billy Silverman, but that was really in the lower abdomen. And then kicks him down with force. the New World Order. What will happen at Super Brawl? What will happen when Savage has a no disqualification match with Luger? And what will happen if Hogan does not get the title back for the NWO? Would that be the crowning jewel? Would that be it?
It'll be like divorce court with Judge Judy. There's going to be so many people running around with their heads cut off, you're not going to believe it.
It's over.
It was over a long time ago.
When he was ready, Kenzan of the New World Order gets the win. Here on Worldwide, and we'll be back with Ric Flair after this.
Hi, everybody. Stagger Lee, Lee Marshall. We got action coming for you, but don't go away because I want to talk about Super Brawl 8 coming up Sunday, February 22nd. If you saw what happened at Sold Out, I'm talking about James J. Dillon and Roddy Piper telling us that the way the heavyweight championship of the world would be decided is Hollywood Hogan and Sting meeting at the historic Cow Palace. And the only way for you to see it is either be in San Francisco or join us on pay-per-view. You satellite owners, contact DirecTV, the Dish Network, or Turner Home Premiere. A lot of opinions, of course, about Hollywood Hogan and about Sting. And matter of fact, I was on the Diamond Dallas Page website very, very recently. A lot of opinions certainly flowing there. It is called the Diamond Mine. Not the Diamond Mind, the Diamond Mine, and I really enjoyed
DiamondMine.com.
You said what's the name of it? I mean, I wasn't giving the address, but if you want to get onto it, it's at www.diamondmine.com.
DiamondMine.com. All right, enough for the Abbott and Costello thing.
Right.
Bottom line is, yeah, there's a lot of information on there. A lot of people want to know a lot of personal stuff about me that I really don't talk about in interviews here. Well, you can find it out there because pretty much I shoot straight from the hip. Kimberly's there, the whole deal. UDC, Union of Diamond Cutters. My boy Rich and KC started it with my buddy Brian Bentley, and together we boomed into 500,000 hits a month.
We were talking about the opinions that appeared on the UDC and the Union of Diamond Cutters, and I'm wondering what you've got to say about, especially Hogan, who, let's just say, whacked you and put you out of Sold Out.
Well, let's put it like this. I'm coming to Sold Out. I was coming to Sold Out until he knocked me out. I am coming to San Francisco, and I am feeling a lot better. I have been rehabbing, and I am right. And I will be putting the U.S. strap on the line. I'm just looking for an opponent. And since you already got one, Hogan, I'll have to find someone else to have feel the bang!
Our thanks to Lee Marshall as the action continues this week on Worldwide Wrestling. Time for our feature bout. As Barry Horowitz, great veteran, will make his way to the ring here. I'll tell you what, Brain, as the countdown goes on, a mere 2 weeks now out from Super Brawl 8. And the fact that Sting and Hollywood Hogan will battle. You know, I seem to think that there has been quite a while, almost 2 months now, and it will be almost 2 months by the time we get to Super Brawl since Hogan and Sting last got in the ring together. This has been plenty of time for the New World Order to come up with a very elaborate plan, not only to secure the world title, but to eliminate Sting from our sport.
Well, before they come up with this big elaborate plan, they better understand that they have to get along. Work out the trouble you have, then come up with this plan. That plan won't work if no one's working together. There he is.
Nature Boy Ric Flair, legendary star in our sport, former 13-time world heavyweight champ, and they all want a picture of Ric Flair, they all want his autograph. He's going to go down in the history books as one of the greatest ever. Young and old alike, respect this man, appreciate what he's done. He's going in against Barry Horowitz here on Worldwide.
And you can compare his record to who?
Anyone.
No one's got the credentials this man has. Matter of fact, I understand he's even going to try to compare records with Will Chamberlain coming up.
He had a classic matchup recently on Sold Out back in the month of January against Bret Hart. Bret Hart won that match, but Bret Hart came out later and said, "Hey, Ric Flair, you are the man. The respect I have for you runs very, very deep. He certainly has earned it." And Ric Flair looking to get back on track to maybe get a major title back around his waist once again.
Well, Horowitz is holding on here, isn't he?
Horowitz realized he has faced Flair before. He realized what he has to do against Ric Flair. Flair is a master strategist, a master ring general, and he knows how to take you down, and he knows once you're down what to do to hurt you. So Horowitz wants to come over with his own game plan to stay as close to Flair and make Flair wrestle his match as possible.
Now, I always, when I wrestle and pull a guy's hair, and the referee would ask me if I did it, I'd say, yeah. What are you going to do? I got a count of four to break. I pulled his hair, so what? Nothing they can do.
Boy, you're arrogant.
No, it's just the truth.
No, you are.
No.
I know it's the truth. You are arrogant.
No.
Oh, yeah, you are.
No.
Yeah.
No.
I'm getting into a whining contest with you. Oh, look at this.
Something's gotten in the man's eye.
Yeah, Flair's thumb.
A dust storm.
Horowitz, thumb to the eye, and then gets shelved.
Well, he ought to wear those safety goggles when he's in there.
No, he doesn't need to wear the safety goggles. You shouldn't do things like that. Shoulder block, midsection. Flair ducking low again. Horowitz up on top. And Ric Flair trying to keep his balance. Oh, he nailed him.
Notice how he spread his legs out a little wider.
Yes.
He wasn't going to go over. This man is so good. Or he wouldn't have won the title 13 times.
Wide vertical base. No.
You can say, well, maybe it was luck. You don't get lucky 13 times. Well.
No, you don't.
Some do.
No, no one. Well,
he does.
Oh! Ric Flair measures Horowitz.
Well, you think even if he got lucky four times, the majority of it, he went out and won.
Yes.
And no other man's done it.
Well, you know, we talked about Ric Flair being 13-time world champ. Here's a cover. Let's think about the men he has defeated to become 13-time world champ. Guys like Harley Race, like the late Kerry Von Erich, like Dusty Rhodes, uppercut.
Yeah, there's no doubt about it. He's been in some of the biggest battles of the
no!
of this sport's ever seen. And he's not done yet.
No, he's not. To the corner, Ric Flair gets a back body drop. Horowitz with a little pat on his own back, and Horowitz with a great drop kick. Horowitz dreaming with confidence now.
Yeah. There's his confidence. Well, you're slapping yourself on the back. Rub it, too. Flair set him up for that. You can see it coming. When you're in there, it's hard sometimes. It's easy to sit back and watch. Armchair quarterback. Beginning of the end here.
Great execution by the Nature Boy. Figure four time.
There'll be another day, Horowitz. Say yes. He did.
He sure did, Brian. You're right. And Ric Flair continues this dominant winning streak, this spectacular win-loss record that he has carried over the years. I would venture to say, I don't know what the record books say. I don't even know if anyone has kept count. But Ric Flair may have the best one-loss record in the history of our sport.
Well, he's got a better record than Bischoff. Bischoff's 0-1.
Hey, I got a better record than Bischoff.
Hey, and you're lame. Here we go again.
Flair! Dropping a big elbow on Mr. Horowitz. Let's sign that figure four, which has won him numerous world titles. As the music plays on, once again, your winner here on Worldwide, woo, the Nature Boy.
For Stagger Lee Marshall, Bobby the Brain Heenan, and Tony Schiavone, we'll see you next week on Worldwide Wrestling. Stop it, please.
WCW Worldwide Wrestling is on the air. Hi, everybody. I'm Tony Schiavone, along with the one and only Bobby the Brain Heenan. 1 week away now from Super Brawl 8. And Brain, what a program we have this week from Universal Studios, Florida.
Always a big program when we're here at Universal down here in Florida. My favorite wrestler is here on the program. The monster himself, Bill Goldberg.
Bill Goldberg will be here later on in this program. You see Barry Houston to face Rick Martel in our opening bout. Plus, Marty Jannetty makes his worldwide debut. And in our main event, La Parca against the Ultimo Dragon. But we start things with Rick Martel, a man who certainly has his sights set on becoming world television champion. To do that, he must go through Booker T.
I'll tell you, Rick Martel's a very, and I mean very, very lucky man. Wasn't a short time ago, a month, 6 weeks ago, Saturn from Raven's flock took Rick Martel and threw him through a plate glass door in Huntsville, Alabama. And I think he just got a couple scratches over his eye, but very, very lucky man. Very talented man in that ring.
Mickey J is the official sign in this, the opening battle worldwide. And Barry Houston now laying some forearm shots in there. In the rope he goes, runs over him. Hooked. One. Only got a one count.
Oh.
Into the midsection, Barry Houston, and a poke to the eye. Barry Houston will elevate and slam him down hard.
You know, this Martel, he started in this sport at a very, very young age. I think he was like 15 or 16.
Cover.
Man's held regional titles all over the place, world titles all over the place. But he has a fiery temper, which has cost him a lot of matches, a lot of disqualifications for this man. He'll lose it real quick.
To the midsection, Martel, put to the gut. Rick Martel showing a lot of fire and vigor here. Up and down. During the course of this program, as you know, Sting and Hollywood Hogan will vie to see who is the next heavyweight champion of the world. We'll take a special look at that matchup coming up in our Super Brawl update a little bit later on here on the program.
You know what I love about being here more than anything at WCW? Is, you know, every month we have a pay-per-view. And every month there's just more people all over the world are watching. And they get better and better all the time.
Martel with a spine buster. And he hooks Barry Houston. And it is the Quebec Crab. And that quickly, Houston tapped out. And Rick Martel opens up worldwide this week with a spectacular win. And it may not be too far down the road that Rick WCW, a television champion.
Well, you know, he's also got a lot of heat with Chris Jericho. Jericho thinks Martel's copying him with his Boston Crab, with Quebec Crab, but Martel's used that long before Jericho ever thought of using it. Big high backdrop by Rick Martel on Houston. Shoots his opponent in. Picks him up for that Arn Anderson side walk backbreaker, whatever you want to call it. And then slaps him into the Boston or the Quebec Crab. Your winner, Rick Martel.
Rick Martel's your winner. As we said, Bill Goldberg is coming up, and he'll be with us next. Right now, we take you to Lee Marshall.
We've got more great WCW action coming up, so don't go away. But first, let's talk a little bit about February 22nd in Super Brawl 8. We're talking about the Cow Palace, that historic venue in California, San Francisco, in fact. If you can't join us on the left coast, then please make your plans. Join us by hooking up pay-per-view-wise, or you Dish owners, contact Turner Premier or the Dish Network. But join us for Super Brawl 8. It's Hollywood Hogan and Sting in a main event in which the World Heavyweight Championship is going to be decided. You're going to see these two great combatants, former heavy... What is it, Disco? Give me my reading glasses. What are you doing? These are my reading glasses.
Those glasses are so thick you could probably see the future. And you know what the future holds?
What's that?
The Disco Inferno in the main event at Super Bowl. It's just, it's chemistry.
No. That's already decided. You haven't heard? You're living under a rock?
What?
Hogan and Sting in the main event in San Francisco. Pay-per-view, the 22nd, out of the Cow Palace. The winner's going to be named heavyweight champion of the world. That is the main event, Disco.
No.
Yes.
All anybody ever wants to see is the Disco Inferno dance. How can you guys promote a pay-per-view card without the main event featuring... in the ring with the disco ball above, the Disco Inferno dancing for the millions of fans worldwide that pay good money to see me?
It's real easy. it's real easy not to have you in the main event because Hollywood Hogan and Sting will be there fighting for the world heavyweight championship.
I don't even look at Sting. Sting is like he's the mime. He's got the white paint on his face. He comes out of the rafters. He can't even dance.
Now you might be there, Disco. You can be in San Francisco.
No, no, I'm only going to be there if they put me on in the main event.
Well, I got a guarantee for you, pal. You're not in the main event.
Well,
Hogan and Sting are in the main event.
No, they don't understand the stroke I get.
You've got
no
stroke.
I can bring on the show with me the Village People. I can get Casey and the Sunshine Band.
Yeah.
I can get the Bee Gees. You get it done, Lee. You got some stroke. Get me in that main event.
If you got all four Beatles back together, you wouldn't still be the main event, my friend.
We're back on Worldwide Wrestling. Still to come some great WCW action here this week. And fans, as you know, we're 1 week away from Super Brawl 8, where Hollywood Hogan and Sting will go into the ring, colliding for the WCW World title, a title that's been vacated. Neither man has the belt, but coming up in 1 week, Brain, one man will walk away from the Cow Palace in San Francisco, the new World Heavyweight Champion.
Well, like Rowdy Piper says, it will be a fight to the finish. You will see a man crowned heavyweight champion of the world. And like I've always felt, I hope Sting does it. I hope Sting wipes the floor and the mat with Hogan. I've always been WCW.
With the exception of maybe one or two nitros right before Christmas time, isn't that the case?
No.
You sure?
I'm sure.
All right, fans, we got a lot more wrestling action to go. Let's go back to the ring this week on Worldwide.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is set for one fall. Introducing first from Baltimore, Maryland, Jumpin' Joey Max.
Jumpin' Joey Max makes his way to the arena.
Another wannabe. He's an NWO guy, looks like to me.
Yeah, and I think he's going to get a rude awakening here pretty soon, though.
Oh, is he ever? Jumpin' Joey Mag will not be jumping.
And I don't mean ravishing Rick Rude either. He shakes the hand of David Penzer. Jumpin' Joey Mag is out. We go back to David Penzer because here he comes, fans.
Look at this.
His opponent from Atlanta, Georgia, Hulk Goldberg.
The single most feared man, I would say, right now in our sport.
And the most talked about athlete in our sport, next to Hogan and Sting. That man right there.
There's a man's man. No nonsense. The fans have taken to him. He comes in with an unblemished record in our sport.
Great submission wrestler. Very strong, very powerful. You know, he takes a hammer when he shaves and pounds the whiskers in and bites them off from the inside. Tough guy.
Joey Maggs. Very confidently pulls on the ropes. Squares up against Goldberg here.
Goodbye!
Forget about a takedown. He's speared him down. Goldberg's gonna waste no time after the spear. Jackhammer!
Oh! There's your winner. No doubt about it.
Here's your winner, Goldberg!
Oh-ho!
Goldberg said, what about that? And what about that? That was awesome once again. Goldberg dominates yet another opponent. The undefeated, unblemished mark continues. Who will stop Goldberg? That's the question on everyone's mind. Right now, the answer is no one.
Well, eventually this man, they say, is going to be packing the gold someday. I think eventually this man is going to be talked about for putting a lot of people out of the game, a lot of people in the hospital. He's a big, strong, powerful man with determination like I've never seen before. The 1-2-3, and your winner, Mr. Bill Goldberg.
The fans, we're going to take you back recently to WCW Monday Nitro. It was Sting against the Macho Man Randy Savage, and Hogan got involved and had something to say before then. Back on Worldwide Wrestling as Super Brawl 8 is on the horizon. Brain, can you believe we're only 1 week out now? Next Sunday is the big event from the Cow Palace in San Francisco that our fans can see on DirecTV with Direct Ticket, cable TV with pay-per-view, satellite dish under Turner Premier available on the Dish Network. Bobby and the Hardwork Bobby Walker make their way out, but for Hogan and Sting to battle, neither man the world champion right now. One man will walk away the world champion. So much focus, so much attention on this most important match in our sport.
You know, in some most title matches, only one man has to win, and that's the champion. He doesn't have to beat the other guy to win anything. But in this one, there will be a winner, and one man will be crowned WCW World Heavyweight Champion.
And I wonder, we saw the footage moments ago from Nitro, the problems that exist with Hogan and Savage, the problems that exist within the NWO. I wonder if there's going to be a little Savage payback coming up at Super Brawl when Hogan meets Sting. Savage is a loose cannon. He's part of the NWO, but they obviously are falling apart, breaking apart before our very eyes.
And that all happened when Hogan lost the title originally to Sting and Bret Hart showing up here at WCW. Since that time, Hogan and the NWO, they've lost it.
The way you can see Super Brawl is by making that all-important telephone call and ordering this event. The event is available on DirecTV with Direct Ticket, available on pay-per-view, satellite dish owner Turner Premier, or, of course, the Dish Network. Hogan and Sting, the tip of the iceberg. Also, Luger and the Macho Man, Randy Savage, no disqualification. Diamond Dallas Page will go up against Chris Benoit for the U.S. Heavyweight title. And we'll also see Scott Steiner and Buff Bagwell, all coming up at Super Bowl 8 next Sunday.
You know, if you ask me to pick a winner, I'm going to have to go with Bob Eaton and hard work Bobby Walker. Look at this dude. You know why? Because of the experience and the knowledge Bobby Eaton has in tag team wrestling.
Look at Bobby Walker walking the ropes. Snapmared him over that time. Walker.
Very agile man to walk that top rope.
Yes, he was. Back to the corner. Whips him in. Bobby Eaton, like you said, a plethora of tag team experience. And it took him a little while to agree to team with Bobby Walker, but they've agreed, and they're looking pretty darn good as a tag team.
Well, Teddy Long put them together. You know, Teddy Long is a very respected manager in this sport. He won a lot of awards from the governor of Georgia and the mayor of Atlanta and different cities. And he put this team together, and he's convinced Bobby Eaton here to give a hand to Bobby Walker.
Snapmare over by Gary Flynn. He drives the knee down to Bobby. Well, the NWO continues to move towards Super Brawl.
Mm-hmm.
Continues to have their problem. There's another problem, I would think, within the NWO, although they would ignore it, is the fact that Kevin Nash continues to powerbomb people with his jackknife powerbomb, continues to get fined at $50,000 a crack, maybe $150 a crack, depending on how severe it is, I guess. And that doesn't seem to bother anybody. That doesn't seem to bother Kevin Nash at all.
Well, that's because Hogan's paying him. We're talking about all these Hollywood money that's floating around here. And he said, I'm with Hogan. He'll pay any fine I get. Well, Hogan is no dummy, as we know. He's a lowlife, but he's no dummy. And he didn't become as famous as he is and as rich as he is by being stupid. And he's not going to keep shelling out 50 grand at a crack because he's got some 7 foot tall loose cannon that doesn't care about spending his money. That'll come to a halt someday. You can bet on that.
I heard Bobby Walker with a drop kick, and on the outside goes Mark Storr. Jerry Flynn still in there, and hard work now. Hooks him up. Oh, Jerry Flynn sent him down. Got a two count.
You know, you talk about world famous venues all over the world, like the Omni in Atlanta, like the Coliseum in Charlotte. And I'll tell you something, all these new buildings, MCI Arena, beautiful facility. But it seems ironic that the Cow Palace should be the home of this one. Hogan, Sting, one man will walk away heavyweight champion of the world, and it'll be from the historic Cow Palace of San Francisco.
The Alabama Jam, that big leg drop from the chop, and Bobby Eaton and hard work Bobby Walker get the win on WCW Worldwide Wrestling. Some Bobby Eaton fans out there. Hard work Bobby Walker, appreciating this team.
That's not Montel. Oh, that's Teddy Long.
That's Teddy Long. You know that.
I couldn't tell with the glasses. You know, when Clark Kent wears those glasses, I can't tell the difference between him and Superman. Can you?
Shut up. Do the replay.
Bobby Eaton here snatches Jerry Flynn and a swinging neck breaker. The Alabama Jam off the top rope. And your winner, a masterful
Bobby.
We come back, Marty Jannetty makes his worldwide debut, and much more as we head to Super Brawling next Sunday.
The news of Jerry Springer.
Next Sunday at Super Brawl, and as we head to the big event next Sunday, four matches, as we said right here, have been signed, but this match, the biggest rematch the sport has ever witnessed in its life, in its history, since 1905.
And you know what I like about it, Shimani? Neither man is a champion. Neither man is a heavyweight champion of the world. So they've got, one's not going to lay back, the other's not going to lay back, they're going to go at it. Because they know this is what it's all about. Hogan can't walk out of there without it, and Sting can't let his fans down. This is going to be tremendous.
Marty Jannetty, with that spectacular movie called The Showstopper, is in his debut match here on Worldwide against William Worthy, and Worthy wasting no time trying to make a name for himself against Marty Jannetty. Jannetty known for tag team expertise over his career, but certainly here's a man who is a great singles competitor and has proved it over the past 2 months he's been in WCW.
Well, he's a nut for training, and he always wants to stay in the top physical shape, and he watches tape of almost every wrestler that there is in the sport, and he tries to pick up things. He tries to watch for people's weaknesses. He does his homework.
Good arm drag takedown by Jannetty, and lateral presses. Randy Anderson says he got a two count only that time. Jannetty, a spectacular fan favorite throughout his career.
Sure, because he's got dimples, that's all.
No, because he's been a great competitor. He's been a success story.
Oh, he waves at the girls, he smiles at the old women, and he pats the kids on the head, wipes the gruel from granny.
What's wrong with all of that?
I don't do it.
Yeah, and people have booed you throughout your career. Worthy with a leapfrog attempt, and Marty Jannetty stopped that hold.
Hey, Worthy didn't have that much hair when he played for the Lakers.
No, that's not James Worthy.
Oh.
It's William Worthy.
I just want to see if you're on top of things, Tony.
You don't know basketball from wrestling. Belly to back.
Sure I do. Didn't you see Goldberg just dribble Joey Maggs and then slam dunk him? And had him for traveling?
Okay. Very good. Pick up by Worthy.
And holding, and he stole third.
Attempted an elbow and a big miss that time. Jannetty showing his quickness, moves out of the way. Into the ropes he goes. Jannetty full arm drag and twist. And Jannetty, here comes. Showstopper. Drives the head and the shoulder. The arm hard down to the mat with the momentum of his body on top. Lateral press, hooks a far leg. Hitting combination. It's over. Jannetty wins.
I tell you why this is a good win for Jannetty. Jannetty gave away a lot of size and a lot of strength. Because the guy Worthy, in my opinion, is more powerful than this man. But this guy knows his craft, and it's wrestling. And what he did is he out-wrestled and shown Mr. Worthy what it's about in that ring. Oh, yes.
All right, Marty Jannetty gets a win, and his debut on Worldwide. Here it is again, Bray.
Worthy picks him up, dumps him over backwards. Think of this, Hogan. This could be you. Better yet, this should be you, having your face roving right into that mat. And I bet you Sting's going to do it. The odds-on favorite to win the championship is a Stinger. Just like it was for Jannetty to win this one. Your winner, Marty Jannetty.
Marty Jannetty with a win, and still to come, our feature bout. Vroom! The stare down between Benoit and Diamond Dallas Page. Mutual respect. Raven gets involved, and certainly Benoit loses his chance to become U.S. champion, but next Sunday, in a rematch, DDP and Benoit will get it on once again.
Bobby Blaze is going to be all right. I can see the intensity in him, the desire to be a winner.
Yeah, he's a fine athlete, and he's had not a bad track record in a short span here in WCW.
Can't even go by that. The guy could lose every match he's had for the first year. And then just click and boom, never lose again. I'd watch out for this Goldberg. He hasn't lost yet, and it doesn't look like he's going to.
Renegade, one of those powerful men in our sport, makes his way out. Former television champ to go this time against Bobby Blaze.
Well, Bobby Blaze isn't going to back off. He's going to just go right at him. He realizes how important it is here on Worldwide to win a match Especially because he knows the world is watching.
All right, fans, want to remind you that Super Brawl 8 is 1 week from this Sunday. Call your local cable operator, satellite dish owners, contact Turner Premier, Dish Network, DirecTV with Direct Ticket, available on pay-per-view. Four matches have been signed, and coming up next week during the Super Brawl weekend, we'll announce more matches for the big event 1 week from this Sunday, Super Brawl 8. Call right now and join us only on pay-per-view.
That'll hurt the back of your noggin.
Well, you're right about Bobby Blaze. He's come to fight, looking good. Drop toe hold and a leg drop on the back of the head.
I have an eye for talent, you know.
You're a shyster is what you are.
No, I have an eye for talent.
You're still a shyster.
Didn't he used to play for Ohio State? Quarterback?
No.
Oh. There's another guy. Blaze, turn it on. Turn the heat up on the man. See, he wants to win so badly. Pick it up, put him in the corner. He hasn't stopped.
Blaze to the attack once again.
Oh, that'll stop you.
Running lariat.
Well, let's see where Mr. Blaze is going to wind up. I remember that backbreaker was used years ago by Gene Kaninsky. He won a world championship with it.
Yes, he did. And look at the arms on Renegade here. Look at the power.
See, he should be pushing down on his chin. That puts more pressure on the neck. Go with him. Go to a yell. You big dummy.
To the attack once again. In the ropes. Power slamming down.
Why pick the man up? You gotta try to cover him. Drop a knee on him. Kick him in the head. Do something. Don't put him back on his feet.
Oh! Back elbow handspring. Renegade. On the attack once again. Blaze sent him in. Northern Light suplex and Blaze.
Hey!
Beating!
Hey, hey, hey! What a win for Bobby Blaze!
But you called it, Brain, this young man with his biggest win to date in WCW with a major upset over Renegade.
Don't get cocky now. Get smart.
Bobby Blaze is your winner. And coming up next, our main event on Worldwide.
This portion of WCW Worldwide is brought to you by Dark City, starring Rufus Sewell and Kiefer Sutherland.
Hi, everybody. Lee Marshall here, and we are going to come back with more great WCW action in just a minute. But let me remind you about making plans to either join us live in San Francisco this coming Sunday. Join us at Super Brawl number 8 at the Cow Palace. Or if you can't be there on the left coast, then make your plans to be there on pay-per-view. Call your cable operator right now. You satellite dish owners, you know who to call, Turner Premier or the Dish Network. It's Hollywood Hogan and Sting, and whoever wins this one will indeed be the heavyweight champion of the entire world. Basically, NWO taking on WCW, and the undercard is beginning to take shape as well. I happen to know for a fact that Diamond Dallas Page is going to be in San Francisco. I think people who have seen this man of late really have to appreciate you on one level, DDP. Not only your hard work, but you seem willing to meet anybody that's at least up to your work ethic. Anybody willing to work as hard as you deserves a shot.
I'm going to ask a question. When is this going to air? When are we live right now?
Well, we're a week away now from Super Brawl in San Francisco.
Well, there's only one opponent on my mind,
mm-hmm.
and that's Chris Benoit. Because right now, I think his work level is hit as high as it can go. If there's anybody who deserves a shot at the U.S. title right now, it is Chris. I've seen the want in his eyes. It's the same as mine. I know what he does in the gym. I mean, here's a cat, I've talked about it before, who started in the dojos in Japan and worked his way up, then beating him to death, crawling out of the dojos. Until he continued to learn and became better and went to Stu Hart's,
yes.
where it all started up there in Calgary. Bottom line is, he's worked his way to being a top superstar in WCW. It ain't about a feud. It ain't Savage Page. It's about respect. And who's ever the best that night will definitely walk out with the U.S. heavyweight title. And the bottom line is, Chris, sorry, but you're going to have to feel the bang!
Thanks a lot, Lee Marshall. All right, next week on Worldwide, scheduled on the program will be Conan, along with Vincent in singles competition brain. They'll be here.
And you never know who's going to be listening to the jukebox. Maybe the Disco Inferno. Along with this big, tough customer, Saturn.
Saturn will be here, and the man we just heard from earlier in this program, Diamond Dallas Page, will be with us as well. It's all in 1 week during Super Brawl weekend right here on Worldwide Wrestling. As we go back to the ring now, tell you, we've got some great main event action. La Parca, the self-proclaimed chairman of WCW, and I say that, you know that because he has that chair he brings to the ring and uses it. He'll be going up against Ultimo Dragon here, but he cannot dance. Disco Inferno's got a little bit of rhythm, but La Parca has none at all.
Well, I'll tell you this much. The Disco Inferno can dance, but La Parca's got that Spanish style, you know? Like you should tie his shirt in a knot and hang around with Little Ricky. You know what I mean? Babalu.
La Parca, one of the most successful luchadors and certainly the biggest luchador.
I wonder if that's a bass or a rhythm chair.
I'm sure it's a lead chair.
Only you'd know.
And he'll face the former cruiserweight champ. The man who was the J Crown champion, 9 titles he held at one time. The Ultimo Dragon. You know, the old cliche is pound for pound, or pound for pound. You can't get any better than the Ultimo Dragon.
And you know that other old cliche?
No, what is it?
That's only, you only know one? But you knew more.
Okay, forget it. I'm not going here with you.
You frustrate me sometimes.
Oh, I do. What do you think you do to me?
If you hadn't said those words, you wouldn't be in the trouble you're in today.
What are you talking about?
Keep saying, I do. You shouldn't have.
The Ultimo Dragon, La Parca, main event time here on Worldwide. Oh. Little karate balancing act.
Ultimo Dragon at one time held, what, 9 titles?
Didn't I just say that as he was walking out?
That's where I heard it. I thought I was just psycho. Psycho.
You are psycho right off the head. You're psycho. And La Parca. Oh, boy. Hard, heavy. Heavy hitting hands that time by La Parca.
He likes to get down, don't he?
I guess he does. Into the corner. Running lariat.
They know each other well, these two.
Oh, yeah. You fans who've been following the sport know that Ultimo Dragon, even though he is from Japan, he resides in Mexico City. It was in Mexico where he made his name. He blocked the leg trip, sending La Parca down. Into the corner, Dragon. There's his balancing maneuver. Sending oh boy, he's so agile.
I thought it was going to be a drop kick.
I didn't.
I mean, like you said, he's now he's so angry, he's quick.
And he's putting on a great display for our fans here of what he's made of. Back body drop again. Down goes La Parca very hard. Look at this. This could be the setup to those rapid fire kicks of his.
Nah, I don't think so.
Oh, yeah.
Well, you were right.
Back leg front kicks, spin kick, a round kick, and a reverse kick to send the man down.
You know what he had for breakfast?
What?
Bowl of kicks.
Thank you. For adding nothing.
Oh!
Oh! Cross body over the top, but he hit hard as well. Out from the platform, all the way to the solid floor here at the Worldwide Arena Universal Studios.
You know what I've noticed here, Tony? These luchadors take a lot of chances, don't they? A lot of suicide chances. Now I see the Americans here at WCW, they're starting to take the same chances. Going to be a lot of people in the hospital.
Well, they have certainly changed the style of wrestling. La Parca with a great counter move. Oh, look at this. Trying to show up Ultimo Dragon, and he's got to pay for it. No, he's not either. He ran right over Ultimo Dragon with a running lariat now, and a cover.
And of all the luchadors, wouldn't you say that La Parca's the biggest?
I said that earlier, too.
I am psychic.
Now you're a goose is what you are. Pick up. Could be a pile driver, and that's what it is. One, two. Amazingly, he gets out of it. How did he get out of that?
He rolled his shoulders.
Well, I know that, but you...
Well, that's where you heard it. You heard it from me now. So why are they yelling for him to drag him?
No, they're yelling the name Dragon. Dragon has an Ultimo. Dragon almost beating. Why do I have to explain things to you, you lame brain?
You don't have to explain things to me. We have to explain to the humanoids. That's why we're here. We're educators, Tony.
Dave's going to get an education next Sunday. Hollywood Hogan. I think an education on both ends about what Sting is made of and about who his friends are in the NWO. One, two.
Could have had him. Oh, that will cost you big bucks.
We have seen $5,000 fines levied to different wrestlers, Scott Steiner in the forefront there, by pushing and shoving referees.
I can't wait till the smoke clears and you hear Michael Buffer say, and the new heavyweight champion of the world. What's his name? Stinger. You know, Buffer forgets sometimes.
Buffer does?
Who?
I'm sorry, fans. I apologize for Heenan. Ducky Lowe there was La Parca.
Thank you, Tony. I hate to do it myself.
You're sorry enough.
Thank you.
Back chop.
Lay on him. Lean on him. Keep him grounded.
Dragon may be in trouble here. I tell you. Oh. Well, as soon as I said that, the Dragon comes in with a second win here. La Parca trying to battle him. Caught him in the sternum. Stunned La Parca. La Parca trying to battle him off. Look at this. But to no avail. Super Frankenstein. Oh, yeah,
wow.
They love it.
You see him slide across that ring on his backside.
And the Dragon sleeper.
He's got him. He's got him good. Now take the mask off. Now let's see what he looks like.
I don't think he wants to do that. Being from Mexico City has respect for the wrestlers and their masks and their heritage. So he won't do that.
You have okay, then he shouldn't take it off. He should just rip the face part off. Or peek in. Let him peek in. Come here.
You have no respect for anyone, so...
I certainly do. There'll be a lot of respect at the Cow Palace. But Parker here drops him on the back of his neck. I thought he had him here. Reminds me of the Giant when I see that. Ultimo Dragon takes him off the top rope. Look at him slide across that ring. Now this is wrestling right here. He hooks him and then stands up with him. And then goes back down with him. And then they ring the bell. Your winner, the Dragon.
All right, for Bobby the Brain Heenan and Stagger Lee Marshall, we'll see you next week on Worldwide. It'll be Super Bowl weekend, fans. See you then.
On this Super Bowl weekend, WCW Worldwide Wrestling is on the air. Hi, everyone. Tony Schiavone and the one and only Brain, Bobby Heenan. We're going to begin with the Disco Inferno in singles competition. But Brain, the excitement that we are feeling right now is because this Sunday, Sting and Hollywood Hogan will finally collide to finally discover and find out who the real world champion is.
There will be a winner. There will be a man crowned heavyweight champion of the world, recognized by World Championship Wrestling. And the other guy will just disappear into the night, like you do, Giovanni.
I don't disappear into the night, but I wish the Disco Inferno would. Disco Inferno and Jerry Flynn in this opening bout. And in this program, fans, on this Super Bowl weekend, we have Diamond Dallas Page in our main event. Saturn will face Super Colo from Mexico. Speaking of from Mexico, Conan is here. Public Enemy and tag team action. And a special look at what went down recently on Nitro, on Thunder. And a very special look at Hogan and Sting. And the big bout coming up for the World Heavyweight title.
Boy, get me a bucket of water. My feet are smoking. You just want to dance when you hear that music. Want to walk up a wall or double vacuum, you know? Just gets in your blood.
Capacity crowd on hand here, Universal Studios, Florida. It's just gone further to Jerry Flynn. And inverted atomic drop. And a lariat from the right side ropes. Say what you want to about him. The Disco Inferno has become a very polished professional wrestler, Brain.
Well, he seems more focused now than he usually has been. Usually now he'd be combing his hair, he'd be dancing, he'd be shaking a little bit. See, he's still got a little bit of that in him. Keep your eye on your opponent. There's what happened. Took his eye off his opponent because he wanted to dance. He still has the tendencies to drift.
Front leg front kicks that time by Jerry Flynn. Former kickboxing star, now a pro wrestler, and those front leg front kicks are awesome. They are right in the rib cage, and the Disco Inferno in trouble here. Into the corner.
Whoa! Oh!
Jumping spin wheel kick by Jerry Flynn. Flynn's got a lateral press the man, and almost came up with a big upset over the Disco Inferno here, Brain.
It looked like he got him pretty good right in the horn as he went over that top rope. Snapmare, took him over.
In the horn?
Yeah, his beak.
Oh, okay, in the nose.
What do you think, he's got a slight trombone?
No.
That's his honker.
But I know he doesn't have a horn either. Into the midsection. And now Disco Inferno battling back, but Jerry Flynn, who certainly has the size advantage here, sends Disco Inferno down, and Jimmy Jett, the referee, with a warning. Well, not only will it be Hogan and Sting, but it will be Lex Luger against the most dangerous man in our sports history, I would venture to say, the Macho Man Randy Savage, in no disqualification this Sunday.
Well, you know, Luger's anticipating, no doubt, getting Savage in that torture rack, slapping him in it where he can't move and get him across his shoulders, but you know as well as I do, Shivani, you can't plan to wrestle Savage. You just go in there and hope you come out of it with something left of you, because the man is totally off the wall.
Cross the throat, cross the middle ropes that time. Almost caught the referee as well. And a back kick. And that jumping spin wheel kick that time caught the man.
Disco smart enough to take a walk, though.
But Flynn is right behind him. He was going to try a standing sidekick that time. Wow. Back leg front kick.
I don't know what goes through his mind sometimes, the Disco. I don't know if he's thinking about Casey and the Sunshine Band, or if he's...
Oh, boy!
If he's thinking about that big ball in the air with a full of mirrors that's shining, or the music. But if he stayed focused, he'd be all right.
Two, three, and he beat him with a swinging neck breaker.
See, when he puts his mind to it, he can do it.
The Disco Inferno, there's the big mirror ball you were talking about, Brain.
The kid with an Arn Anderson down.
Could you stop it?
Oh. Never mind.
The Disco Inferno celebrates. And the fans enjoy.
Looks like win. Jody Foster, don't it?
No, it doesn't.
Okay, Buster Brooks.
Time for our Snickers replay here on WCW Worldwide Wrestling on the Super Brawl weekend, and the fans are just having too much fun here.
Well, how do you know it's too much fun? You ever had too much fun?
Yes, I have.
Not me. Well, Disco's not having too much fun there, neither is Jerry Flynn. Disco's got his dander up, you might say, right now, and he's mad. Think Jerry Flynn with a swinging neck breaker, he's had enough. It's the 1-2-3, and your winner, the Dancing Man, Disco Inferno.
Hungry? Why wait? Snickers brings you our replay here on WCW Worldwide as we take you to this very special interview.
Well, this Sunday, available only on pay-per-view, it's Super Brawl number 8. And I think it's rather poetic that one of the most historic events is going to take place in one of this sport's most historic venues, the Cow Palace in San Francisco, conjuring up memories of the likes of Ray the Crippler Stevens. Well, I want to talk to another man known as the Crippler Chris Benoit, because you're going to be facing a challenge in San Francisco, Chris. It's Diamond Dallas Page. Fans all over the world saw what happened when you and Page got together the last time. It was a disqualification. elimination. I know Paige did not want to win the match that way, and I know that it was Raven and his flock that, well, really got into your hair. Now, if you want to take some advice from me, I'm not a coach and I'm certainly not a wrestler, but Chris, you've got to get Raven, you got to get the flock out of your mind and concentrate only at your opportunity to fight Diamond Dallas Page for the U.S. heavyweight title.
In my opinion, Diamond Dallas Page, one of the greatest athletes to have held the U.S. title. When they said it was all over, you showed them it was just beginning. When they said you can't, you did. And now they're telling you don't, and you are. I got a lot of respect for that, DDP. That takes a lot of backbone. But you're looking at someone that enjoys breaking bones, that enjoys inflicting pain. And although I've got a lot of respect for you, DDP, once that bell rings, that respect goes out the window, because it's about V for victory. As for you, Raven, you think you got my number? You're going to find out exactly why they call me the Crippler.
Fans, it's going to be either this man or Diamond Dallas Page that leaves San Francisco as the United States heavyweight champion. I want to wish you very good luck, Chris. Certainly good luck to your opponent, Diamond Dallas Page. Fans, don't forget, Sting and Hulk Hogan, they're going to meet. A world championship is going to be decided this Sunday, the pay-per-view in San Francisco. Call your cable operator right now.
All right, fans, we're back on WCW Worldwide Wrestling from Universal Studios in Florida. Tony Schiavone and... Bobby the Brain Heenan. This is the big Sunday they've all been waiting for, Brain. Super Brawl 8 is this Sunday on pay-per-view. DirecTV with Direct Ticket, the Dish Network, and Satellite Dish Hunters with Turner Premier. The big return match, Hollywood Hogan and Sting will vie for the vacated world title. Two men walk in, neither with a belt. One man walks out this Sunday, the world champ, either WCW or the NWO.
You know, everyone thinks that Sting's going to go in that ring and he's going to beat Hogan from pillar to post just like he's done before. Sting, do not count this man out. He's been there before. He's been to the big money matches. He's been in big money matches like this before. Hogan, Sting, both of you have to be your top-notch best. Only the lucky one will win this one.
It could be luck that wins it, fans. It's all this Sunday, plus other great matches that we'll be talking about as we go back to the ring on Worldwide Wrestling.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following is a one-fall tag-team contest. Introducing team number one from Sturgis, South Dakota, Mean Mike and Tough Tom, Disorderly Conduct.
That's right. Mean and Tough is what we're all about.
You got to be mean and tough to beat from Sturgis, South Dakota,
Universal,
and here they are.
Disorderly.
Yeah. Just to beat the bugs off your wall.
Mean Mike, Tough Tom coming in this tag. This is going to be a great tag team encounter here on Worldwide, because they have to face two very tough dudes as well. Public Enemy will be coming out here.
They all deserve each other.
For these two tag teams?
Sure.
Hey, why not? Let's send you back to the ring one more time into David Penzer.
Their opponents are from South Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. Flyboy Rocco Rock and Johnny Grunge, the Public Enemy.
Here they come, Public Enemy, and they always start a party when they come to the ring, Brain.
I thought I saw that one to Critter. Oh, yeah, everybody's here ready to dance, ready to get down. The furniture movers are here.
They bring in their table, and that means there could be trouble for any team, any athlete in the ring against them. Well, on this big weekend, Super Brawl Sunday, when we see tag team wrestlers and we see tag teams competing, we think about the big tag team return match where the Steiner brothers, the new champs, will defend against Hall and Nash, the Outsiders, in a return bout. That is coming up this Sunday. We'll talk about that during the course of this matchup. But fans, we have to step out for a commercial break. The match will get started. It will show the match in its entirety when we come back from Universal Studios, Florida.
Stojanovic and Sally Amuwa for 1-800-COLLECT.
Every time we go on the road, I get stuck with Dan. We've got nothing at all in common. Except 1-800-COLLECT. We both dial 1-800-COLLECT when we call home. It's fast, it's easy, and it's inexpensive.
Man, they stuck me with a...
The bell sounds, and I tell you, Disorderly Conduct. Tough Tom and Mean Mike, they're taking the fight right to Public Enemy here. Johnny Grunge can barely get up as Rocco Rock goes down.
How about this start for disorderly conduct here, Brain?
Well, that's the way Public Enemy likes it. They like to be pounded down, they like to be kicked around, and they like to do some kicking and some pounding also. Yeah, they bring their tables and chairs when they come to wrestle, don't they?
I tell you, they are one tough duo, this Public Enemy, and they are the former World Tag Team Champs. Steiner Brothers have battled through adversity. Steiner Brothers are in WCW as now the Tag Team Champs, and they will have to defend those belts against the team they defeated, the Outsiders, coming up at Super Brawl this Sunday. Into a lariat, full Nelson pickup and a side salto. How about that?
Kind of having his way with the man.
That's right, doing and Johnny Grunge.
You realize they always bring a table to ringside.
I realize that.
But Parker always brings a chair with him. Right?
Yes.
Can you imagine just letting those guys run wild at rooms for us?
Yeah, I say, someone bring the silverware. We could have lunch. One, two. Two count.
Just let them fight through a furniture store. Wouldn't that be great?
They have certainly used the table to their advantage, not only to win matches, but also to dish out a little payback on enemies and opponents. Mean Mike will make a cover here. One, two, and got a two count as Rocco Rock kicks out. Not only are they tough, but they are very tough to keep down. Up on the middle and a moonsault. How about that?
You know, he surprises you with some of this stuff. You don't think the guy can do it, or would do it, or can do it, or even thinks about doing it, but all of a sudden, there he is going through the air. And there's his other half-wit partner.
Well, they compliment each other quite well. What do you mean, half-wit?
Did you let him do your taxes?
No.
Half-wit.
I'd let him take care of my fights, though.
Oh, yeah.
How about that? Out of the way. And a power slam. One member of disorderly conduct down on the floor.
Are they pointing to the table?
Mean Mike is in trouble here. Well, the fans are chanting table. They're going for one of their pending moves. The double team on the top. And Public Enemy gets a win. How about that?
Well, they've got him standing here at Universal.
Here comes the table. Charles Robinson's telling him, hey.
Now, you know nothing's going through their mind right now. They're just thinking about how they can put disorderly conduct somehow through that table. They don't really have a plan. Their minds are just running amok. Yeah, they're all right. Now the asylum blocks, two more.
Disorderly conduct leaves the scene when the table goes in the ring, and that brings Public Enemy into the stands to celebrate their win with the fans. So ladies and gentlemen, this Sunday is your opportunity to see professional wrestling history, where the two biggest stars in our sport will battle for a second time. This time, neither man is the world champ. The title vacated. But this Sunday, when Sting of WCW and Hollywood Hogan of the NWO collide, they will vie for the most prestigious title in the world. Take a look on Worldwide. Well, there's another part to that story. As you saw the NWO stomping Sting, stomping Savage, stomping Luger, caught in that big net that dropped down. The other part of that story is, and we're going to show the fans later from Thunder, the same week, last week, where Hogan comes out and demands an apology to the Macho Man Randy Savage. He gets slapped in the face. And then, when Luger met Ric Flair later on the same telecast, once again, Savage and Hogan get into it. I mean, the NWO is really falling apart, Brain.
Oh, they're really falling apart, and especially since Hogan lost the World Championship to Sting. And with Bret Hart coming on the scene here at WCW. Everything's just falling apart for Hogan, Eric Bischoff, Hall and Nash. They lose the Tag Team Championship. Diamond Dallas beats Kurt Hennig for the United States title. I mean, a lot of things are happening to these guys. Now they declare war on all of us.
They declare war on all of us as Big Rick Fuller comes out. But I really think, war or not declared on the NWO, I really think this is just scare tactics by the New World Order to try to take the attention away from what's going to happen this Sunday. Because you know and I know, if Sting brings the world title to WCW, coupled with the problems they're having with Macho Man Randy Savage, the NWO may just dissolve, fold up, implode.
And you're right about that. As long as we hold on to all the championships, and as long as Sting is in the fold here, the Dusty Roses and the Hulk Hogans and the Eric Bischoffs in this world can get their own little commune someplace on a desert island and just live there forever and have National Hulk Hogan Day, 365 of them, tell them what a great guy he is. That'd be fun, wouldn't it?
Wow. Conan of the NWO and Rick Fuller. Lariat from one side, tumbling through, and then the other side. And he's out here with Vincent. What a duo they are, huh?
Yeah, they're a couple of guys you want to see come to the door for an escort.
Vincent, roundhouse right side of the head.
This is the real deal right here, bud.
Vincent.
What a guy, huh? What an organization, this NWO. Chock full of liars, backstabbers,
cutthroats,
egomaniacs,
thieves.
They deserve every rotten thing that's happening to them right now. And, you know, they deserve Randy Savage. I'm glad they got him. I'm glad he's disrupting things the way he is. And this Sunday when Sting and Hogan get in the ring, I wonder how much disruption he will do.
Well, Savage had the rough one first with Luger. You know, that's the no disqualification, and Luger's going to have the same advantage as Savage has.
Having problems with the fans here.
Who's the guy in the front row dressed like the Serta mattress?
I don't know these fans, and I wish you'd leave them alone. These fans are the reason that you're who you are. These fans have made you and me. You understand? Their dedication to our sport, their love for our sport has made us what we are. So leave them alone.
Did I get in trouble if I ripped the tag off his shirt?
Conan with a tequila sunrise on Big Rick Fuller.
Back to stone brushes, Mr. Fuller. It's over.
Conan will not let go. Vincent running interference for him here. He can get a fine levied on him here.
A mean looking man, isn't he? Extra little crank there. Yes, I like that.
You do?
Yes, I like that. Shows tenacity.
Shows he's a jerk. Vince, we're going to take you back and show you the footage from Thunder we were discussing in a few moments, plus Diamond Dallas Page in our feature about. Also this Sunday, we're going to have some other great matches, including a man we're going to see a little bit later, Diamond Dallas Page, defend his U.S. heavyweight title against Chris Benoit in a return bout. And as Super Colo comes out, we're also going to see the man he's going to face here this week on Worldwide, Saturn, go after Booker T in the TV belt. That's all a part of Super Brawl. All major titles will be contested this Sunday. Chris Jericho's cruiserweight belt, where it's going to be belt against the mask of Juventud Guerrera. We talked about the Steiner brothers defending the tag team belts in a return bout against the Outsiders. All major titles on the line in one big night this Sunday, Brain.
This is the big one. This is the big one. Like Rowdy Piper says, throw him in there. Let him go at it for the world championship. Now, here's a bad customer this Saturday. This guy's a bad customer.
And he will face Booker T for the television belt this Sunday at Super Brawl. Former television champion. You're right. You're not kidding. He's a bad customer.
Look at the beady eyes on him. Now, he really has beady eyes.
He looks like a gargoyle. I've said it many times.
Come on, get him out of here. Come on.
But he is so tough.
How'd you like to be looking through a mail slot and have him look back at you about 2 in the morning?
I don't think I'd like to do that.
You ever open a pair of drapes and peek in someone's window about...
No, I have not. What are you... To the midsection. Drop kick. Two count. Super Colo is prepared for, or at least I thought he was, for center.
Oh!
How about that? Member of Raven's flock. And I believe the flock's out here, aren't they? Yeah, they are. You saw them in the bottom of your screen right there. They're all sitting out here. And that makes it doubly tough for anyone, Colo or even Booker T, this Sunday, when the TV title will be contested, to go in the ring against Saturn.
You know, this is sneaking up on us. I don't know if you're aware of this or not, but you know what happened with the NWO. Hall and Nash, Hogan, few people showed up. All of a sudden, it mushroomed into this huge corporate pain in the ear.
Yes.
Well, that's what's happening with the flock now. They're growing. Week after week after week, they're getting stronger and they're getting more dangerous. If we don't watch it, they could overtake WCW. I don't know if they're bright enough or they're clean enough, but I'll tell you something, they're certainly dangerous enough. With the right person behind them, they can be very dangerous.
You saw on the bottom of your screen Lodi. Boy, he is a goof. Look at this.
Yeah, he's got a little identity problem there.
Does he ever? He's there ringside with Saturn.
You know, Saturn is like a Benoit. So explosive with his moves, compact.
Very physical, very aggressive. Hello with a moonsault. 1, 2, and he almost beat Saturn. What a major upset that would be in the same weekend where Saturn must vie for the TV belt.
What does Lodi do?
He does nothing. He's an idiot, okay? Nothing.
He does nothing?
He designs signs. Signs are up. And there is the rings of Saturn.
You mean he prints?
He prints. The rings of Saturn. And quickly, Colo gives up. And next for Saturn, a chance to bring the TV belt back to the flock and back to the feet of his leader, Raven.
Look at the eyes on this man.
What are you looking at?
Not me. Shivani. I've always liked you, Saturn. You know that.
Raven comes into the ring along with Kidman. There is a bizarre individual right there, guys.
Never talk to his flock, but they all know what he means.
Look at this now. Along with Kidman, Riggs, pounding away on a helpless Super Colo here. Here's our replay again, Brain.
They go against the power of Saturn. Dumps the man on the back of his neck. Takes him over again. A couple of those will really soften you up. And then the rings of Saturn. Once again, another win for the flock.
Now let's take you to the footage we discussed earlier from Thunder. It all started with Hogan in the ring, declaring war on WCW, and wanting an apology from the Macho Man Randy Savage.
The time has arrived. This Sunday, live on pay-per-view, as well as DirecTV, it's Super Brawl 8 from San Francisco, California. And at Super Brawl, we will crown a new World's Heavyweight Champion. Title currently held up, but the biggest rematch in the history of pro wrestling will see Sting face Hollywood Hulk Hogan. Now, in addition to that, I'd like to bring in at this time the former World's Heavyweight Champion, the total package Lex Luger, and Lex at Super Brawl, it's you and the madness that is the Macho Man Randy Savage to be contested under no disqualification rules.
I know I sound like I'm out of breath like I ran up the stairs just now, but let me tell you something. I'm almost out of breath just thinking about the rematch I have with the Macho Man. You know, everybody says he's such a loose cannon on the fringe, outside the fringe. He called me out on a no disqualification match. You know what, Mach? Nobody ever forgot. I'm no choir boy either. You set the rules, you called for the match, and I'm taking you up on it. And you have just raised the ante, hasn't he? Week in and week out. But Macho Man, something's going on here with the NWO with Macho Man. And what that tells me is that you don't have a friend in the world, Macho Man. So when I got you down, when I'm ready to put you up in that torture rack, There's be no NWO guys to save your butt. So, Macho Man, get ready for a no disqualification match, because I'm as ready as I ever have been in my career.
Lex, it almost seems as if you're playing right into the hands of Randy Savage with the no disqualification rules.
Well, Mike, I've got a few tricks up my sleeve as well, because I wasn't born yesterday. Like I said, I'm no choir boy. No disqualification match, I wouldn't take this match on if I didn't have a plan. And Mach, I got a plan for you, and it's spelled R-A-C-K.
Lex Luger and Randy Savage, all a part of Super Brawl 8. It's time to order now.
And before we go back to the ring for our feature bout, here's what's going on next week on Worldwide. Big Ray Trailer will join us in singles competition next week. In addition to Ray Trailer, we are going to see Eddie Guerrero, former Cruiserweight and U.S. Heavyweight Champion. He'll be with us. That should be a great matchup. And also the Cat, a man on a mission, a man who's been looking for his former friend Glacier. He'll be with us. And then Mortis, along with James Vandenberg, will join us. Mortis, as we found out, trying to become a member of Raven's flock. That's all next week on Worldwide Wrestling. So we go to the ring now.
Well, why would anyone want to become a member of the flock? What's the advantages to that? Explain that to me.
Okay, if you had your choice between walking around with a creep like Vandenberg or going with Raven's flock, what would you do?
Well, now, Vandenberg is not a creep. He's a very interesting man.
He's a creep.
Oh, him and I have discussed many of he collects oddities, you know.
Yeah, I know he collects oddities.
You should see some of the things he has. They told me about and showed me some of the brochures he has and the things the man wants to buy and purchase. Oh, no, and
he's right out of a Wes Craven movie is what he is.
And then running around with the flock. Now, they're not bad to watch from a distance.
So high.
But you don't want to really run with them.
Here he comes. The sign of the Diamond Cutter, Diamond Dallas Page, United States Champion, who has agreed to a return bout with Chris Benoit. And I think that just tells us, I don't think there's any question that Diamond Dallas Page is a fighting champion. Willing to put the title up against Benoit recently on Thunder. We saw how Raven got involved in that. And then has agreed to a return bout with Benoit this Sunday at Super Brawl.
Yeah, but tell him how he got into this. He's the champion, right? No one challenged him. He went and gave Benoit a shot.
That's what I was saying. Fighting champion.
I mean, but you never volunteer for anything in life. That's when you get dumped on, when you volunteer. You always let everybody else do the work, then you just slide in and take the credit. You should know that by now. You're here long enough.
Yeah, I've worked. Hey, what are you trying to say?
Then you do an excellent job here.
Bozo. All right, Yuji Nagata, Diamond Dallas Page. You can just feel the excitement here in the arena at Worldwide Wrestling. You can feel the excitement at Universal Studios. And I know this Sunday in San Francisco, that sold-out crowd at the Cow Palace awaiting the biggest return match ever, where all titles will be on the line this Sunday at Super Brawl. DDP and Yuji Nagata, they know each other quite well.
You know, the important thing on this one, Tony, is Hogan's got to know it. Hogan's got to convince himself that he can take this man, Sting. Because if he don't, he can't go back to the rest of the members of the NWO, to the Nortons, to the Scott Halls, to the big Kevin Nash, to Vincent, to Dusty Rhodes, to the Japanese contingent, to Buff Bagwell, to all the members, and say, I failed, I dropped the ball. He said, Savage dropped the ball. Savage never made it to so high on the ladder. Well, if Hogan don't become champion of the world, that whole NWO thing is going to not crumble. It's not going to fall apart. It's going to explode right in everyone's face.
Nagata pounding the back of Diamond Dallas Page right in front of your good friend Celiono here. Oh, now look at this. Choking DDP. What a cheat.
Now, wait a minute. You saw him put both hands on each side of his head, right?
Yes.
And then you saw him jump up on the apron with both feet, right?
Yes, we all saw all that.
Don't you know what that means? That's a Japanese greeting.
One, two. Gotta two.
It is. When you grab a man by the ears.
You're an idiot. Roll up in. One, two. I'm not even letting you explain this one.
into the Japanese greeting, into the midsection. Down goes Nagata. And here's a cover by Yuji. Did he beat him or not?
No, I don't think so.
I'm Mickey J saying two, and Sonny Ono says, hey.
Time for another greeting.
Right. He should have won the match, but DDP firing back now. Blocks it, right hand. Right and left combination. DDP picks him up. Inverted atomic drop.
Oh!
And the tornado lariat.
Where am I? Am I in Kokomo, Indiana, or downtown Nagoya? Shake off the cobwebs here.
I tell you, he was going for the diamond cutter. You saw the sign there, and Nagata put him right in the eyes with a thumb, and he comes away with a diamond cutter.
So much for Mr. Nagata. Bam is right. He's not going anyplace.
Self high five. Thank you. Diamond Dallas Page gets the win on Worldwide Wrestling. And now for DDP, Chris Benoit, part of Super Brawl 8 this Sunday, the night where Hogan and Sting collide for the vacated world title in the biggest rematch our sport has ever seen.
Yeah, that's custom. When a guy grabs you by the ears, he puts both feet on the apron, it's called Mitsu Arakawa. You put your nose to his nose, and you say in Japanese very quietly, I hope your sister's swimming. First of all, Diamond Dallas here takes the god out of his shoes just about. Follows him into the ropes, catches him in the diamond cutter. And there's your winner, Diamond Dallas Page.
Fans, this is the weekend we've been waiting for, and you want to be a part of all the excitement of this Sunday. And that is because, as DDP shows us his diamond cutter, this Sunday, you can make that one and...